March 23rd, 2012, 26 giddy MCHS students, staff, and chaperones jetted off for Europe, bound for their first stop on their spring break getaway. There's only one problem. The baggage handlers at Toronto had called a wildcat strike, which delayed the group's flight. Although time was reclaimed during the flight, they still had to run through Frankfurt Airport to catch their Lufthansa flight. When we got to Berlin, we were all a little tired, but in good spirits as we boarded the bus to our hotel. We toured the city a little bit that evening and saw a building that has as many floors as there are days in a year. After that, we rode the Berlin equivalent to the LRT to the Berlin Zoo. Some of us went shopping for gifts while others toured the zoo, learning about the various kinds of animals that live amongst us. The Berlin Zoo is the oldest and best-known zoo in Germany. Opened in 1844, it covers 84 acres and is located in Berlin's Tiergarten. With more than 1,500 different species and around 17,500 animals, the zoo presents the most comprehensive collection of species in the world. Some animals we are shocked to find there, like cattle and goats. They even had a miniature world water park for the various seabirds there. After enjoying our encounters with the animals, we went for dinner and back to our hotel, where, for obvious reasons, we crashed. The next day, we again took Berlin's S-Bahn to the heart of Berlin to go on our city walk tour. The East Berlin Ampel Mansion was created in 1961 by traffic psychologist Karl Peglau as part of a proposal for a new traffic lights layout. After the fall of the Berlin Wall, the Ampel Mansion acquired cult status and became a popular souvenir item in the tourism business. We then walked over to Museum Island and the Berliner Dom. After a brief tour of Museum Island, we trekked over to the Berlin War Veteran Memorial. Just across the street, we visited the spot where many Germans burned books by Jewish authors. We ventured under Brandenburg Gate, which is a former city gate and one of the most well-known landmarks of Berlin. It's located west of the city center at the junction of Unter der Linden and Ebbestrasse, immediately west of Kaiserplatz. One block to the north stands the Reichstag. A short jaunt south took us to the Memorial to the Murdered Jews of Europe, designed by Jewish-American architect Peter Eisenman in 2005 to the tune of 27 million euros. Lots of Berliners wondered if it would have been cheaper to offer a free bus service to Sachsenhausen concentration camp. Nevertheless, we took a walk through to appreciate Eisenman's work. From serving as the Nazi Luftwaffe headquarters to serving as the Communist Berlin headquarters too. What else? The tax office. This seven-story, 112,000 square meter building saw the July 1953 uprising in East Germany when citizens protested the increasing Stalinization of the country. All these little holes that you see here, most of those are bullet holes.
The Berlin Wall, that ominous barrier between communism and democracy, was torn down symbolically yesterday when East Germany opened its borders to immigration and travel. But today, sections of the wall are being knocked down physically, not just by kids, but by soldiers of East Germany as well as citizens.
After visiting the Berlin Wall, we proceeded to the Jewish Museum, where we learned about Judaism and experienced many symbolical moments.
It's pretty spooky.
From above, the new part of the museum is supposed to resemble a broken Star of David. We then headed to the outskirts of Berlin to see the former summer palace of King Frederick the Great of Prussia. Sanssouci was built in a Rococo style to serve as a relaxation place for Frederick, away from the pomp and ceremony of the Berlin court. Among the comforts of the palace were multiple miniature greenhouses for growing grape vines for wine. When he died, he wasn't buried where he wanted to be. After the reunification of Germany, he was reburied in a tomb next to his dogs overlooking his gardens. We then ventured inside the palace. The marvelous detail in the statues and the careful attention to the structural detail was breathtaking. The chandeliers were stunning, and the walls and frescoes on the ceilings were drop-dead gorgeous. In one room, there's graffiti left by soldiers in 1945. The next day, we took off for Prague, stopping briefly in Dresden. After having a blast in Dresden, he was off to the Czech Republic and its capital,